Welcome to Fireside Chat. My name is Sai. If you're new to my channel, I talk about how I budget, save, and invest money to achieve financial independence. In one of my previous videos, I talked about how my fiance and I plan to prioritize our savings and investment as soon as we get married. Our Fat FIRE number is $2.8 million with 4% withdrawal rate. That should give us about $100,000 a year in passive income. That can be a combination of our stock market portfolios, HSA, and real estate. We also have a plan to invest at least $1 million in our dividend stock portfolio with 4% dividend yield so we could achieve lean financial independence with $40,000 a year. I will post these video links in the description below so you can check them out. In this video, I'm going to talk about what type of budget strategy my fiance and I are using to achieve financial independence and retire early. With our budget strategy, we can save at least 60% of our gross income into savings and investment. In September, I made a 3-minute video on the 5 common budget strategies people use to pay their bills, save money for their short-term goals, and invest their money for their long-term goals. There's the pay yourself first budget strategy, the zero-based budget strategy, the 50-30-20 budget strategy, the envelope budget strategy, and the value-based budget strategy. My fiance and I will have several sources of income, and we have no debt except for our mortgage. When you don't have any consumer or student loan debt, it's so much easier to just focus on our savings and investment. When I was paying off my debt, I used the zero-based budget strategy to use every dollar to pay off my credit card bills and loans. Since we are debt-free with the exception of our mortgage, we're going to use the pay ourselves first budget strategy. What that means is that when we make our budget, we will always prioritize our savings by putting away at least 50% of our take-home income. If our expenses are too high to meet the 50% savings rate, then we find ways to lower our expenses. This budget strategy can work for anyone if you're not in toxic debt like credit cards, student loans, or personal loans. We organize our budget after we have contributed to our 401k, pension fund, IRAs, and the HSA, because most of them are coming directly from our paychecks. Our pre-tax contributions are the state pension fund, which is about 15.25% of each paycheck. The HSA is pre-tax contribution at about $200 every paycheck, not counting the employer contribution every fiscal year. You can check out my other video I made in detail about our plan to retire with HSA. Our post-tax contributions are the Roth 401k, which is about $750 every 2 weeks, and that totals to $19,500 every calendar year. We also contribute $1,000 every month to our separate Roth IRAs, and that totals to $12,000 every tax year. These contributions are automated, so we never see them go directly into our checking accounts. From there, we focus on saving at least 50% of our take-home income and using the other 50% to pay for our expenses. We increase our savings rate as our income increases. We do not increase our expenses or lifestyle just because we got a pay raise. Our essential expenses are what we need to keep a roof over our heads. Here are the bills we absolutely need to live in our house: mortgage, HOA, and utilities. We also budget our groceries, household items, car insurance, life insurance, medical and dental bills, and any other annual expenses. You can also check out my other video about how I budget for my annual expenses, and I will post the link in the description below. Next, we go into the discretionary spending. We have separate spending accounts that are dedicated for entertainment and travel. We contribute as much as we can every year to these accounts so we can travel and buy birthday and Christmas presents. Remember, you're not supposed to be miserable while you're on the FIRE journey. When you're debt-free, you have to learn to have fun and enjoy your life. By the way, if you need help with your personal finances, you can schedule a free 1-on-1 20-minute financial coaching session. You can fill out the introductory form by clicking the link in the description below. Also, don't forget to hit the like button if you enjoyed this video so far, and subscribe to my channel with the notification bell. My next video is going to be about how Dave Ramsey's Baby Steps 1-3 saved me from living paycheck to paycheck. The next thing we budget for is our additional investment. My daughter's 529 college savings plan and UTMA are relatively low on our priority list because I transferred my GI Bill to her name when I was active duty. We want to prioritize our taxable brokerage accounts, especially with dividend investing. If we can consistently save anywhere between $30,000 to $40,000 a year, and put any additional income sources into that account, we should be able to generate $40,000 a year in dividend income. The dividend income will primarily pay for our essential expenses when we achieve financial independence. Now you may be questioning my budget strategy because you feel it's impossible to save half of your income into your investment accounts. I also understand that everyone's situation is different. This video is about changing your mindset about saving and investing for your future. Could you save 50% of your income if you made $60,000 a year? Absolutely. I did it when I was single making $60,000 a year and I didn't feel like my budget was too tight. I just cut out the expenses I did not need. I always budget it after I have maxed out my 401k and IRA. Your income is supposed to go up over the years. If not, then either you're stuck doing the same thing at the same pay level or your employer is not paying you enough. If you're serious about joining the financial independence journey, you have to find ways to increase your income. Now is the best time to ask for a raise or switch jobs. The demand for workers is still red hot in the job market, and the US economy only added 194,000 jobs in the month of September. That's far below the more than 500,000 expected. Labor supply shortages right now are forcing employers to raise wages to find and hire new workers with talent. If you're a working couple, take a look at your budget and see if you can live on one person's income. If your spouse makes $40,000 a year and you make $40,000 a year, can you live on $40,000 a year and save the other $40,000? Most of the time, it's not an income problem. We have a spending problem. The common misconception is if you make $100,000 a year, then you're rich. The truth is, 18% of Americans earning a salary greater than $100,000 are living paycheck to paycheck. Business Insider did an article on the millennials who call themselves the Henrys, which stands for high earner, not rich yet, making between $100,000 to $250,000 a year, but still feeling broke. That's because they have expensive habits like staying at luxury hotels, taking international vacations, and doing other fun activities. This is all while they still have massive student loan debt. Between their debt, high cost of living, and the upkeep of a lavish lifestyle, Henrys feel like they live paycheck to paycheck. So my suggestion for people who are still in debt is to use the zero-based budget strategy to throw every dollar, every penny into your debt and keep your expenses very, very low. You can't grow your wealth if you still have balances on high-interest credit cards at 20 to 25% or student loans at 6 to 9%. When I had $100,000 worth of debt, over half of my paychecks went to debt repayment, and I did that when I made less than $60,000 a year. You have to be willing to make some sacrifice to get rid of your high-interest debt to get on the financial independence journey. Once you finish paying off your student loans, credit cards, and personal loans, then you can start budgeting for your fun activities. Keep in mind, you should budget for your fun activities after you have invested into your retirement accounts. My fiance and I budget for our entertainment and travel because we don't have any consumer debt, student loan debt, or credit card debt. We want to have fun while we're on the financial independence journey, and I want you to have fun while you're on your journey. Thank you so much for watching my video. Let me know in the comment section down below what your thoughts are on the Pay Yourself First budget strategy. If you need help with your personal finances, you can contact me by filling out the introductory form, link in the description below. Also, don't forget to check out these two fire videos and my Instagram page. I will post a new fire video every Saturday and Sunday at 9 a.m. I hope to see you in the next video. Have a good one. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more fire videos.